निकाल ले रहा हूँ, मैं तो चाहिए नहीं।
There are, who has joined, they can...
Wait for some time,
no? 4:20 is back.
चार
लोगों
को भी दिख रहा
हूँ। हेलो, हाँ काय ते तुम्ही जाणार होते का त्यांच्याकडे? अच्छा अच्छा हाँ हाँ बर बर आहे, थोडा वेळाने चालेल तुम्हाला? एक पाच मिनिट ना बर हाँ हाँ हो चालेल, मग तुम्ही सांगा, तुम्ही पोहोचले ना की कॉल करा फक्त। हा व्हॉट्सअप कॉल करा, काय प्रॉब्लेम
नाही।
ऍक्च्युली इंटेंशन होता फिजिकल
आपका
हेलो
हेलो
physical meeting we are able to
six topics are nikala hai aur kuch issues of stall process of see hai and society the termination in new buyer the effect on the new buyer quarterly written upload ka agar koi mechanism aaya nahi hai to unko okay ye jab tak nahi aata hai tab tak builder koi
kadam nahi hai
ha then bank ka project finance and cost of the project uske upar quality ka bank project finance bhi hua fast resolution bhi hai aur member tenant ka bhi hua aur din nahi pata the usko
patra nahi hai nahi ye bond ki present ki
cost ka denge sir rate ke bada
20 and present to somebody
जूम में कैसे वो
स्मॉल
टाइप
सीखता है actually what difficult you are facing while in the very clear
wo chalo isko mat na
to mere piece
baki sir also the issue which you are
concerned let me that can be
is a process
but of course sir ye aaye sare component jo kiya tha hamara
sare ke mein chale
bande
सर का सेशन चल रहा है, हो गया अच्छा ओके ठीक है, मैं आता हूँ, नो प्रॉब्लम। So now the new study group which will get formed
every year, new study group currently convener,
correct?
Is a
okay
meeting mein aaya group form hoga,
yeah group form
main convener sign।
नहीं आई डिडंट फाइंड द इकोनॉमिक यू सेड मी इकोनॉमिक लॉज राइट दिस इज अ कमिटी ऑफ डब्ल्यूआरसी
यस यस लास्ट ईयर शिल्पा सिंगवारे वाज
नहीं कमलेश साबू
कमलेश साबू
कमलेश साबू का देखो लास्ट ईयर का
नहीं बट मैं कमिटीज के लिस्ट में ही जा रहा था स्टैंडिंग एंड नॉन स्टैंडिंग
सर विच कमिटी यू आर टॉकिंग सर
इकोनॉमिक एडवाइजर राइट कमिटी ऑन
ये दिस इज आईसीएआई सर आईसीएआई न्यू दिल्ली कमिटी सर
अभिजीत केल
ऑल इज लेवल
एंड विकास जैन सर इज वाइस चेयर ये नया अपडेट हो गया
अभिजीत केल इज द चेयर विकास जैन इज वाइस
हां मतलब न्यू अपडेटेड है मैंने कहा वो इसीलिए आई जस्ट सो
This could be at central level,
no? No, this is at WRC level. WRC level. वो नीचे होगा सर कमिटीज में.
कमिटीज में?
हाँ. नीचे. हाँ कमिटीज में होगा WRC.
बीच में रहेगा. गुड आफ्टरनून ललित सर
गुड आफ्टरनून सर
कैन यू हियर मी
ड्यू टू मार्च एंडिंग लो आई कांट एबल टू मीटिंग सॉरी
संजय सर हाउ आर यू
फाइन फाइन
सिंगल पर्सन है
तीसरे को मैं कौन करी
एवरीवन इज देयर ऑल वे ऑफ वर्क
ऐसे ही मुंबई अपन हम पूरा पड़ो
इकोनॉमिक लॉज वाला था
मीटिंग ओके इकोनॉमिक कमर्शियल इशू कर वाला ना पहले कॉर्पोरेट एंड अलाइड लॉज था
अच्छा ओके
इकोनॉमिक ही था
ना नहीं कॉर्पोरेट एंड अलाइड लॉज था ना
ऐसा भी कोई अलग से है क्या एक से कॉर्पोरेट मेरे को ऐसा मिला नहीं दूसरा
नहीं कॉर्पोरेट वो सेंट्रल सेंट्रल कमिटी का सेंट्रल कमिटी सर ये 2017 में इन्होंने रेरा का स्टडी ग्रुप बनाया था ऑल इंडिया लेवल पे
विजिट किया था
आई वाज अ मेंबर ऑफ दैट कमिटी सर एट दैट ईयर
सर आर्टिकल फॉर बिलो देयर इज अ प्रोग्राम ओनली स्टूडेंट्स आर देयर सो आई विल जस्ट श्योर इट्स सो मच सो सॉरी सर थैंक यू थैंक यू Thanks, yeah. Thanks,
OG. You can join later on.
Yes, I'll just finish that. Thank you so much. एक बार उनका क्या last session चल रहा है? Only
special day. Thank you.
Party में घूमते
हैं। उससे भी याद रहेगा कोई ना कोई।
Okay, so good afternoon, everybody. For the first time in our tenure as a convener, me and Aditya, we have kept this meeting as a physical meeting. And I welcome everybody who is there, who has joined us in this meeting on an online mode. And I also welcome today's our panelists, CA Sunil Naik sir, Ashwin Shah sir, and Dilip sir. We all know them. They are our near and dear ones, and they are the part of our RERA study group only. So today we are going to speak about we are going to discuss the future of the CA profession and RERA and how now CAs can make themselves more capable to offer more and more services and more out of it. How can they generate more out of this all this RERA machinery mechanism? So now I request the speakers to start with the discussions. So I request Ashwin sir to open it up.
So I welcome you all
And thank you, convener and joint convener, for arranging the last meeting being a physical meeting. So at least we can meet in person. I also welcome my co-panelist, Sunil Naik and Dilip Agrawalji. Both are well versed with the RERA law. Now RERA is not a newborn baby now as of today. We are already almost near to completion of 5 years of practice in RERA. As said, the act was introduced in 2016, but all the practical provision, registration, compliance, litigation, everything got started in from 1st May 2017. So on this 1st May, RERA will be completing 5 years. So we'll today's meeting or discussion rather, we would be focusing on what has happened in this last 5 years, what was the intention of bringing RERA into the statute, exactly what has happened, and what more is expected, and how a chartered accountant can contribute in terms of certification, financial disclosure, as well as recommendation to state government and central government, including various Maharera and Gujarat RERA authority, so that ultimate goal is that real estate should not be killed. Because I can say that one real estate project gives employment to nearly 250 various kind of workers, or skilled worker, or like painter is there, plumber is there, and so on. So it gives employment to 250 such kind of people, and it contribute after, I think, agriculture. This is the second largest sector which contribute to employment also. So that way we, and India again is a home hunger country. Even today we have many people who are striving to upgrade themselves from slum to one room kitchen or 1 BHK, from 1 BHK to 2 BHK, and so on. So, and there are many homeless people also. They just stay on the railway station or in a very slum area which are not hygienic. So as such, every year we have ample demand for home. Now just look at the one announcement, that only 1% stamp duty is increasing from 1st April, and there is solid rush before March for registration, paying stamp duty, and so on. So this shows not only in metro, but now small cities like Valsad or such small cities, Surat, Valsad, they also, now there is so many activities going on in real estate after the COVID, particularly after the COVID. So because of COVID, real estate is affected to a larger extent, because real estate requires the presence of, physical presence of all the multi workers like architect, engineer, PMC staff, skilled, unskilled labor. But when there was a COVID, entire activity was halted because of lack of supply of material, migration of labor. That was the main issue. Because of COVID, many labor migrated from Maharashtra to their native places. We have seen on television how they migrated. They went by rickshaw, scooter, or by walking also, right? So with this, now I will request Sunil to say something as a opening remark.
Good afternoon, friends. Basically, as a RERA practitioner, we look into 5 things. Which I'd like to highlight here. First is, and the most important function of a chartered accountant in a RERA project is structuring of the project, which means financial closure as well as disclosure of right information in the right manner. Give a simple example. If the project cost which you're going to define is coming to X amount of money, the revenue generation is going to be Y amount of money, which means that by default you're showing Y minus X as the profit, which your client may not be showing at the end of the project. So while structuring the project for registration, you have to make sure that the figures are in sync with what you are going to propose ultimately for the project. So here a chartered accountant is required to give those estimates and give the advice to the client, so that he doesn't show wrong numbers or doesn't project wrong numbers, which can be detrimental to him itself in time to come. That is the first point. Second, registration, as we are all practicing in that area. Third is the procedural compliance, which is now become very mandatory because RERA wants a quarterly compliance. We're going to discuss that aspect in the few minutes from now. Then we go to certification, which is our domain, which is given to us as chartered accountants. So friends, that is an exclusive practice being conferred upon us. So it is actually our right as an obligation and responsibility to make sure that we give proper justice to this work. Otherwise, this certification, which is being given to us only as a monopoly, may go away to other professionals. So friend, this is an area where we have to be very, very vigilant because departments are interconnected. All the data of RERA is being shared with GST, is being shared with IT. So all the information has to be in sync with each other. Otherwise, there can be a situation wherein we can come into trouble, or our insured also may come into trouble, or the RERA authority may think of other professions also to render the same service. Then next is litigation. Now this is the area wherein we are not the most proficient persons, but as Ashwin can vouch for me, we have been trying to make inroads into this practice, and to be very honest with you, we are quite successful in dealing with this practice also, and we can really give a run for the money to the senior advocates and the solicitor also, because our institute has taught us to be vigilant, to be more introspective, to understand the matter as a wholesome matter and take the litigation forward. So here, because of our knowledge of the entire subject, we are in a better position to litigate on behalf of the client, and we can be more successful than the other practitioners. So friends, all these five areas are the potential areas for all of us as chartered accountants. And in case we really strive hard, then we can set up a total RERA practice on this subject, and that can be the backbone of your entire practice in time to come. This is a practice where there is a monopoly, so make sure that you make inroad into that and try your best. Now I'll hand it over to Dilip ji for his further remarks. Thank you.
Thank you, Sunil ji, and thank you, Ashwin bhai. You have very well said, and I think there are something which I can add here is, the topic is RERA and the professional future outlook for chartered accountants, right? And if I go from very straight, then I can see roti kapra aur makan. And roti kapra aur makan mein makan to compulsory essential item mein aata hai. It means anything, any industry will require makan for their people, employees, or even owners. And every one of the under the earth will need makan. It means this work cannot stop. It means RERA, if continues, then practice will also continue. But only depends on how, what perspective we are taking on in this area. If I look at our professional colleagues, I can relate them. They are indulged most of the in different areas, and they are not focusing in this. Hardly, maybe two dozens of professionals I could have seen in the last maybe 5 years. Those who can be regularly seen on various platforms regularly, and others are just becoming part of either they are increasing and upgrading their knowledge to just survive. Now, game has changed. Our economy has changed. We are now becoming amongst top countries. And why we as a professional, who are the people leading and guiding people to come along with the government policies, national policies, then only thing which is lacking here is for us as a professional, the outlook is we should choose really what is more important for us to be excellent in particular area. And this is upcoming area, rather than if you look at income tax, if you look at other part of your practice, people are saying ki hum to muskil se survive kar rahe hain, abhi hum kya kare. I am just citing one example. Some Sohan Chhatani, my colleague, 20 years back I had gone to Satna. And only one or two things we had done, and then he called me, Dilip ji, mere ko aapki yaad aayi.
कि अभी हमको बहुत तकलीफ हो रहा है कि मैं क्या करूं, अभी प्रैक्टिस में कुछ दम नहीं रह गया है, अभी इतने सीनियर हम सीए हो गए और हम आज सरवाइव कर रहे हैं कि हमारी प्रैक्टिस कैसे चलेगी, हम कैसा घर चलाएंगे, तो क्या हम इस चार्टर्ड अकाउंटेंट की डिग्री को इस तरह से अपॉर्चुनिटी वर्सेस हम करने को तैयार है क्या? पहला तो माइंडसेट अपने को चूज करना है, बिकॉज अंटिल यू लीव समथिंग मैं इसको पकड़ के भी रखूंगा और मुझे रेस में दौड़ना है, तो क्या समझते हो आप रेस में भाग सकते हैं? ऐसा ही हो रहा हमारे प्रैक्टिशनर्स के साथ, हम और आप रियलाइज करो कि आपको लगता है मैं छोड़ दूंगा तो ये भी चला जाएगा। अ वर्ड इन हैंड इज बेटर देन टू बर्ड्स इन द बुश, ऐसा कुछ कहावत है, तो मैं बोलता हूँ कि वो सब कहावत कई और चीजों में लागू होती है। इधर आपको चूज करना फ्यूचर है, आपका फ्यूचर आउटलुक है। रेरा इज वन ऑफ द बेस्ट अपॉर्चुनिटी, इधर भी जाने वाला नहीं है, एंड वी हैव टेस्टेड एंड सीइंग द इफेक्ट ऑफ इट। 5 साल में 10,000 प्लस लिटिगेशन आ गए, ऑर्डर्स आ गए उसके, एंड सो मेनी केसेस आर स्टिल पेंडिंग, एंड वी प्रोफेशनल्स आर नॉट जंपिंग इनटू दिस प्रैक्टिस एरिया, एंड एक एक केस में लोग 25,000 से लेकर 2 लाख तक चार्ज कर रहे हैं। तो आप उसमें आप समझ सकते हो कि जो हम अदर प्रैक्टिस में करते, यू कैन कंपेयर विथ, पूरे साल जीएसटी का रिटर्न भरते मैंने सुना है 15,000 एक क्लाइंट से लेते, अरे क्या लेते हैं इतने में, तो हमारे को हमारा असिस्टेंट भी नहीं मिलता है, आर्टिकल भी नहीं मिलते, फिर क्या खुद करते हैं? तो डू वी जस्टिस विथ आवर ओन प्रोफेशन? प्लीज वाट एवर वी आर सजेस्टिंग अदर्स, वी शुड सजेस्ट आवर सेल्फ, वी शुड टेक गाइडेंस फ्रॉम आवर कॉलिग्स। अब प्लेटफॉर्म ये जो स्टडी ग्रुप बनाया ही इसीलिए जाता है कि यू शुड गेट सम इंस्पिरेशन until your outlook is changed, you are not going to change your everything, it may take some time, ये बनने को 3 साल लगता है, तो प्रैक्टिस में तो 2-1 साल लग सकते हैं भाई, और रेरा प्रैक्टिस इस्टेब्लिश हो गई, ओनली सिंगल एक्ट है, छोटा एक्ट है, 92 सेक्शन मेरे ख्याल से 92 सेक्शन है, एंड इतना गिना चुना में आपको 15-20 सेक्शन कर लिए तो आपका बेरा पार है, कुछ और करने का नहीं है उसमें। आप यदि रजिस्ट्रेशन में घुसना है तो 5-10 सेक्शन से काम चल जाएगा, लिटिगेशन में जाना है तो उसमें 5-7 सेक्शन पकड़ लो हो जाएगा, और बहुत ज्यादा नहीं कुछ करना है तो गिन के 1-2 हाई कोर्ट सुप्रीम कोर्ट के ऑर्डर आए हैं उसी को आप अपना बाइबल बना लो, अपना गीता का सार समझ लो, आपका पूरी नैया पार होने वाली है, कुछ कुछ बोलना नहीं है आपको, गिने चुने पैराग्राफ के बारे में रिपीट कर दो, आप एक्सपर्ट कहलाओगे, इससे अच्छी अपॉर्चुनिटी किधर मिलने वाली है। नंबर टू, जैसे मैं ये देखूं कोविड ने आपको कितना अपॉर्चुनिटी दिया, वर्क फ्रॉम होम, आप भी सीखे हम भी सीखे, हम लोग अपने आप को टेक्नोलॉजिकली अपग्रेड कर पाए, इफ वी हैव रियली अपग्रेडेड आवरसेल्फ, तो एक चीज तो बहुत क्लियरली समझ में आ गया, वर्क फ्रॉम होम में घर में टीवी चलती है तो हमें एक रूम और चाहिए, यानी जिसको 1 BHK था, एक बेडरूम है और हॉल है, तो उसको एक सेकेंड रूम की जरूरत है, यानी रियल इस्टेट 50% एक्सपांशन रिक्वायर करता है, जहां भी आप देखो हर किसी को एक एक्स्ट्रा रूम फॉर द पर्पस ऑफ ऑफिस वर्क फ्रॉम होम के लिए चाहिए, वो एम्प्लॉई हो तो भी, भाड़े में जा रहा हो वहां पे भी उसको लगता है कि यार 20,000 भाड़ा की जगह 25 लगे, लेकिन एक एक्स्ट्रा रूम चाहिए। आई मीन टू से एक्सपेंशन इन द रियल इस्टेट इज अनरिस्ट्रिक्टेड, इट हैज टू गो, हैज टू गो मीन्स कंप्लायंसेस पार्ट विल इंक्रीज, नंबर ऑफ प्रोजेक्ट्स विल कम। मैंने रेरा जो कोविड पीरियड में है उस समय जो बोलते हैं ना शेयर बाजार में बुल एंड बियर का जो स्टोरी है वो इधर दिख रहा था, ऐसे अनेकों लोग थे बोले अभी मार्केट किधर जाएगा, कुछ ठिकाना नहीं, एवरीथिंग इज अनसर्टेन। एट द सेम टाइम मोर देन 1,000 न्यू प्रोजेक्ट्स गोट रजिस्टर्ड ड्यूरिंग द कोविड पीरियड, जब सारे लोग सोए थे वो 1,000 प्रोजेक्ट के जो डेवलपर थे वो जगे हुए थे, उन्होंने वो अपॉर्चुनिटी को ग्रैब किया, तो मुझे लगता है कि वो जो ग्रैब किया वो आज के लिए बेनिफिशियल है। मैं उसकी बात नहीं करता जो 15 साल से चल रहे और थके हुए आज तक अटके हुए, वो एज ए प्रोफेशनल फॉर अस टू गिव देम सम एक्सेस सो दैट दे कैन कम आउट ऑफ इट। ज्यादा लिटिगेशन है, देर आर स्टोल्ड प्रोजेक्ट्स, उसको बाहर कौन लाएगा? प्रैक्टिशनर्स, प्रोफेशनल्स। और उसमें आज रेरा में देर आर 3 professionals mainly engaged. One is architect, other is engineer, third is the chartered accountant. और advocate भी engaged है. बट अभी आप देखोगे मोर प्ले रोल इज गिवन टू द चार्टर्ड अकाउंटेंट. ऑल कंपाइलेशन इज टू बी डन बाय होम बाय अस एंड इन द प्रोसेस नॉन रेरा वर्क लाइक आप ऑडिट करते हो रेरा का ऑडिट भी कर लो उसको बोलो भाई रेरा का करते तो हम दूसरा भी कर देंगे आपका काम. आपके एक्सपेंशन है आपके एसोसिएट्स है आप जीएसटी एक्सपर्ट्स हो वो सब काम आएगा बिकॉज ऑल थिंग्स आर एप्लीकेबल. बट मेन फोकस इफ यू कीप ऑन द रेरा देन रेरा इज योर सर्टिफिकेशन एवरी क्वार्टर नीड टू बी डन. देर आर मेनी डिटेल्स विच इज रिक्वायर टू बी अपलोडेड विच नीड्स सम प्रोफेशनल नॉलेज वी चार्टर्ड अकाउंटेंट्स आर वेल इक्विप्ड एंड देन एनुअल ऑडिट अंडर रेरा इज ऑल्सो वेरी इंपॉर्टेंट पार्ट. उसमें दिखता तो बहुत छोटा पार्ट है बट जब आप करने रियल में जाते हो तो जो प्रैक्टिस में है उनको मालूम है रेरा में उसको डेप्थ ऑफ द सर्टिफिकेट क्या है बिकॉज रेरा एक्सपेक्ट अस टू मॉनिटर द प्रोजेक्ट. दे हैव नॉट जस्ट गिवन यू टू गेट सम फीस फ्रॉम द डेवलपर एंड इंक्रीज योर इनकम. दे हैव पुट ओनस ओनस रेस्पॉन्सिबिलिटी ओनस. कुछ रेरा में हमने सुना था कि कुछ ब्लैक लिस्टेड भी हो गए बिकॉज ऑफ द सर्टिफिकेट बेस एंड दे कुड नॉट मैच विद something and then RERA took action, disciplinary action and such kind of action if started, believe me, aap aur hum jo isse really connected nahi hai, professionally connected nahi hai, we are not getting the professional real income, not putting our efforts, then we may be penalized. And apart of this, jaisa Naik sahab ne abhi bataya, some of us may destroy the profession. Jaise aaj नरेंद्र मोदी साहब या उनके अंडर गाइडेंस में देर आर अदर कमिटीज आर गोइंग टू बी फॉर्म देर आर अदर इंस्टीट्यूशंस आर कमिंग. आपके लिए वो दिन दूर नहीं है जब रेरा में हमारे सारे चीफ फ्रेटर्निटी के लोगों के सर्टिफिकेट के बेस पर जब कुछ काम नहीं हुआ है फिर भी सर्टिफिकेट वहाँ कनेक्ट होगा तो एक दिन एनालाइज करके वो बंद कमरे में डिसीजन होगा कि कुछ फायदा नहीं है सीए को ये सारा अथॉरिटी देके इनसे अथॉरिटी ले लो कुछ और नया रास्ता निकालते बिकॉज ये लोग मैनिपुलेटर है. मैं आई एम नॉट ब्लेमिंग बट आई एम टेकिंग ऑन मी बिकॉज आई एम सीइंग आई एम रिव्यूइंग वेरियस प्रोजेक्ट्स आई एम सरप्राइज टू सी द क्वालिटी ऑफ द सर्टिफिकेट्स विच वी एज ए प्रोफेशनल्स आर पुटिंग देयर. यू विल शॉक टू अंडरस्टैंड व्हेन यू विल सी सर्टेन सर्टिफिकेट्स. आज जब डिसीजन होते हैं तो वहां पर कोई एक क्वालिटी वाला आदमी होगा अंदर में and they can put some influence and then ek din malum hoga jaisa GST audit chala gaya waisa RERA ka bhi kuch kaam compromise ho gaya. So I mean to say hum sabhi logon ko ye dekhna hai ki hum really professional outlook perspective se isme bahut badi industry hai ye and it can be 20% of the whole country's economy. It is not aap when we go for real estate even industry mein bhi construction work bahut hone wale. इंडस्ट्री यदि लगेगी तो उनके एम्प्लॉयज के लिए भी बहुत सारे घर मकान लगने वाले हैं. ऑल दोज विल कम अंडर दी समवेयर इट विल बी कवर्ड एंड वी बीइंग प्रोफेशनल्स एंड वी कैन गाइड देम एंड वी कैन एक्सप्लोर आवर इनकम. दिस इज समथिंग. नाउ कंप्लायंसेस पार्ट मोस्ट ऑफ द थिंग्स आर ऑलरेडी देयर. वी आर वेरी ओल्ड नाउ वी नो व्हाट आर द थिंग्स रिक्वायर्ड अंडर द RERA. कंप्लेंट्स फाइल कर सकते हो लिटिगेशंस में गाइडेंस दे सकते हैं कंसिलेशन में जा सकते हैं RERA के प्रोजेक्ट रजिस्ट्रेशन में हम उनको सलाह दे सकते हैं कि इतने बड़े लेआउट पे आपको किस प्रकार से कितने प्रोजेक्ट रजिस्टर करने चाहिए और आगे क्या इम्पैक्ट होगा कितने फाइनेंसेस के इम्पैक्ट आएंगे कहाँ कहाँ पर आपको. अभी तो CA का फॉर्म नंबर 3 भी बदल गया है फॉर्म नंबर 5 में भी चेंजेज है. ऑल दोज थिंग्स नीड योर एक्स्ट्रा ऑर्डिनरी some intuition about how you can advise the builder because it is not a simple thing ki usme kuch bhi figure dal do aur ek bar kaam chal jayega. Once you put estimated is estimated you have to only pay some fees to change it but all are recorded. So income tax pe kya impact hoga when they are going for the bank finances udhar kya impact ho sakta hai. Everything we are supposed to guide to the builders and get our appropriate remuneration. यदि आप कुछ ब्रॉडर फ्रेमवर्क में उनसे बात करते हो तो वो आपकी बात का ड्यू रेस्पेक्ट विद ड्यू फीस आपको रिवार्ड देते हैं. और आप मेहनत खाली करते हो क्वालिटी नहीं शेयर करते हो तो आपके फीस सब्सटेंशियली डाउन होती है लाइक जस्ट नॉर्मल प्रैक्टिस. मैं आपको इतना ही सलाह देना चाहता हूँ कि आवर RERA इज अ न्यू एरिया नाउ देर इज नो डिले. 5 years में एटलीस्ट आपने खट्टा मीठा हम लोगों ने स्वाद चखा है. आपको सिर्फ मीठा ही स्वाद चखना है. आपको एक खाली डिसीजन लेना है कि आप ये डिसाइड करो कि हम पकड़ के दौड़ना नहीं चाहते. यू हैव टू लिव इट बिफोर यू रन. द मोमेंट यू डिसाइडेड दिस तो आपको स्पीड करोगे थोड़ा देर में थक जाओगे रेस्ट करोगे. एक प्रैक्टिस करते करते 2-4-6 महीने में यू विल बी हैविंग हैबिट टू रन अप्रोप्रिएटली विद द स्पीड रेरा इज गोइंग ऑन. दिस इज कम्प्लीट. हैंडिंग ओवर टू सुमित जी.
आपने एकदम सही कहा. वेरी लेस प्रोफेशनल्स एज फार एज आर प्रोफेशन इज कंसर्न आर एंगेज. वेन एवर वी आर इन द स्टडी ग्रुप का मीटिंग वी सी ओनली द सेम फेसेस हु आर अपीयरिंग. देयर इज अ लैक ऑफ न्यू फेसेस. सो ओके कंटिन्यूइंग द डिस्कशन.
सो नाउ द क्वेश्चन इज how we can give value addition to the developer, because developer is a person. Correct. Who is a very smart guy.
Correct.
He knows all the intricacies of the project. Correct. And talking to a developer for 1 hour, he can find out your technical fault, your technical weaknesses of a chartered accountant or even advocate also. So a developer is a very smart person. So then how we should be geared up to give the value addition? We should focus on that, because now so much data mining is there, is available on Marera portal also. So in one of the case, when the developer, it was the first meeting, so just it came to me. So now we have one tape, that is recovery warranty is also available on Marera website. So I, before that meeting, we just searched this project. So we find out one recovery warrant was issued. So then I talk, okay, there is one recovery warrant issued in your project. No, no, impossible. It cannot be. Developer was so confident. I said, it is there. I showed him. Then he, after some communication with accountant and all this, it was a case like this, okay, there was a settlement. He has paid the money to the allottee also. But recovery warrant was issued. Recovery warrant was again deposited by the allottee also in the Marera office, but it remained. It is there on the site today also. So now then we applied to Marera that this is a mistake. You remove this recovery warrant. Because now bank are also looking at all this data before giving any project finance. All recovery warrant, complaints, all these are being also looked by the bank. So we need to gear up ourselves. See, we cannot practice in a traditional way. Like just certification form 3, just take up the form 3, fill up. And sign, you didn't create karo and certify karo. That time has gone. Now we have to be one step ahead. Like what Dilip bhai also rightly said. Now I have seen many projects which are registered in 2017. If we look at the, if we log in into the through login of the promoter, we find that only one form 3 is uploaded, that is of July 2017. Thereafter there is no form 3 is uploaded. Now just imagine, after 17 there is certainly per square feet rate increase of at least 500 to 600 rupees. More than that include, then there are approval fees, all that increment is there. So in one of the case we found out that 1000 rupees per square feet is an increase which is never shown in the estimate. And again, this income tax department can always look at form 3. They can ask copy of form 3 from Marera whenever they want to call for the information. So this is also one point of value addition, where we can tell the developer, look, first you judge your profitability, how much is your revenue, how much is your cost, whether it is in consonance with form 3 or not. In many of the projects, this is the first impression we should create before the developer. Your data are not in consonance with what is reflected. And in one of the faceless assessment which I have heard from one of the officer, see, it happens sometimes that there is an ex parte assessment 144 and all. So the faceless officer, he took RERA proportion as an income of the developer, 70-30. 30 is your profit margin. That's why RERA has given 70 and 30 ratio. So straight away, he estimated revenue, whatever may be, and then high pitch assessment was done. Now that matter is maybe in appeal or whatever. But these are the difficulties. So we have to change our way of working. Like, we should not be just looking at opportunity of quarterly certification and annual audit report. There is something more than that. So builder should believe that, yes, by retaining this consultant, I am going to get something value addition. Then he will pay. Then if you ask 1 lakh rupees also, he will not bargain. Otherwise, for certification, if we ask, say, 20,000, he said, no, others are doing in 15,000, 12,000. I will not give you. So we have to show our strength, how we can be helpful to them in the value addition. Yes, Sunil, what is your view?
Yeah, honestly speaking, you know, our role as a chartered accountant is not only certification. That's the thing that we have to understand first, because that is an adjustment that you do to yourself. It's a mental adjustment that I am competent to do much more than certification. I'll just give an example. The brochure to be drafted by the developer, that brochure has to be in consonance with RERA. RERA gives you the indication, the advisement, how it has to be put across, correct? So that is a stipulation put under the law. When the developer is formulating the advisement or his brochure, you should be there with him. You should be there to contribute to that entire exercise so that he doesn't make any contravention of the law. For example, a simple thing, like in a phase management project, in the 3 phases, if you're going to plan a swimming pool in the 3rd phase, so that it has to be mentioned in the brochure that phase one does not have a swimming pool. In case you don't mention it and there is a complaint tomorrow, you will get beaten up by the authority because you have made a wrong promise. And in that situation, there can be a complaint against you where you may have to refund the whole amount of money to a potential allottee also. So this is there in the law. The builder may not be knowing this. He may go out of the way to please the client by showing a beautiful brochure wherein those things which are promised may not be existing or may not be contemplated to be given by the developer. So this is the area wherein the CA comes into play. We feel that we are only accountant and we know only finance. No, that is not the case. If you know the law well, you will be in a position to guide them on each and every section of the law. Each and every section is important. For example, I just give you as what Ashwin bhai just now said, that when you plan the project, when you make the financial closure, when you make the first estimate, to estimate the profitability also, what is going to be the revenue potential, what is the cost estimation given by the engineer, whether the profit which will be resulted out of that is the profit you are going to show, whether your client is ready for that. Even the 70-30 thing, 70-30 is not the right proportion. In Mumbai, you may have a proportion 95-5, 95 will be the expenditure. But if you give this wrong notion to the developer, that only 70 is the expenditure, then he will end up in a big mess. So he may go on starting withdrawing 30% and then at the end of the project, you may find you are short of funds.
Yes.
So here it is your job as a chartered accountant to tell the client, look, 70-30 is by the law, but as per the actual project, it should be 95-5. Don't tamper with 25%. You are the only person who can guide him on that subject. So this is our strength. Actually, we don't understand what is our strength. In case we can put our strength on the table and convince the client that this is what we can do for you, then your fee will actually add 1 more 0 to the billing amount.
Yes.
This is what my personal experience is, and we are charging it and people are paying us also. Secondly, as Ashwin bhai said, for the certification, if it's a 20,000 is my fees, don't touch the client. He's not a good client for you. What we say, I'll charge you 1 lakh rupees, but I will give you a delivery of the product which will take care of your well-being in the future. A wrong certificate issued by a chartered accountant is a wrong percentage of work completed, can lead to a lot of difficulties for you in the future. These have to be understood by all of us. We should not be issuing a certificate just blindly. I have seen many chartered accountants, especially younger ones, who just blindly issue a certificate. That is not done. That is not the right way of doing things. And in case they are going to charge 5,000 rupees for that certificate, they are messing up with their own life because there can be penal action against them in the future. Plus, then making life of CAs like us who are RERA consultants difficult, because then we can't charge the right amount of fees. We give the best product and we get less fees. That is not to be followed. So all CAs, if they unite together, we have a situation of monopoly here. This I tell everybody in all my lectures, this is the first time that the chartered accountant is put on the revenue side. All this while we are on the expenditure side. We should advise the client about GST, about government payments, about company formation, all the expenditure items. Here's the first time that you are going to be on the revenue side. Unless you issue form number 3, there is no registration. Unless you issue form number 3, there is no bank withdrawal. which means that you are in command of the project. We have an advantage there. Lakshmi samne se aayi apne ghar pe. We should understand that yes, it is there for us. We are leaving the opportunity and then making a mess of our life. See, the proviso to form number 5 clearly states, in case the certificate issued by a chartered accountant or an architect or an engineer is found to be wrong or misleading or having wrong contents, then the action can be taken by the institute concerned on that person, wherein there can be a dismemberment also. So there can be a situation that in case you don't do your job properly, we end up having that misery of dismemberment. So friends, take this very seriously. If you know the law well, then you can advise on each and every point of the law, whether it is a brochure, whether it is the potential of the project. For example, I'll just give you an example. In case you want to add something to the project, then you require consent of the members. Now, if you have planned a project properly, if you're expecting 1 lakh square foot of FSI in time to come, go for the full potential. People go in for the present potential available and do not consider the future potential. What happens is that when the future potential comes into play, at that point in time, you have to go back to the allottees for their consent, which may not be forthcoming of you because of your own actions or inactions. So that is a situation you may end up. So if you plan it properly right now only, then that misery of going to the allottees for that permission will not be required. So this can be factored into the registration process itself by all of you. Then the most important thing is review of the project on timely basis. We are not supposed to only issue the certificate, wait for the client to come to us for the certificate and issue the certificate. No, that is not a right way of doing things. You should be going to the site, paying proper visits, understanding from the architect, you interact with the professionals concerned, and then come to your decisions. So if you contribute on the table something from your expertise, then yes, you are entitled to get a proper remuneration. What we are doing right now is that we are not giving our expert opinion or expertise and sharing it with the developers. So they don't know our value. And we also don't put the value on the table. As Ashwin rightly said, the value addition should be coming from your end. If that comes from your end, then you are entitled to charge that amount of fees which they will readily pay to you. In litigation, we have seen that the advocates or the solicitor who come, they charge a bill of 50,000 per appearance, and we chartered accountants are still lagging in 10 and 15,000 per appearance. This is absolutely not done. We are more capable than them. We are almost matching them. We can do better job than them, which is my confidence, and we have been doing it. So friends, you have to understand that this is your inner strength. Go for that strength and then you start making more money out of it. See, the law is already formulated. It is given to you on the table. It is what you can do out of that law is the challenge. There is no challenge from the industry. Challenge is within yourself. If you understand your strength and really take hard effort for that, you will certainly encash on it. That's my view. We have been doing it for the last 5 years. And honestly speaking, we have been very successful in doing that. And we have been charging fees which are almost on par with the advocates and solicitors, and they are paying us. So, friends, this is an opportunity, but depends on how much effort you put in. And in that proportion, you will get the returns back. Our fraternity is that way, very lax, in the sense that, chal raha hai, thik se yaar, naya kaam kyun karna hai, naya kaun sikhega, apne ko jamega nahi. That is the preconceived motion that we have. And because of that, we are in difficulties today. So, try to come out of that and we'll be 100% successful. I think Dilip bhai can talk more on this.
Yeah, very well covered, Sunil bhai. And you have touched the main point in the practice. I could capture two things. First is our fight with our own brothers, sisters in the same profession. Someone who is charging 5,000, other is charging 50,000. There is a vast gap. The person who is charging 5,000 is happy, and the person who is charging 50 deserves to get 1 lakh. Those people who are charging 5,000 are making more difficult for those really practicing. This is what I could get, and real. And we are also facing the same thing. Now, to explore in this area, the best way of developing yourself, or grooming yourself as a RERA practitioner, such smaller platforms are always welcome. not only by the WRC. WRC has given you the platform, but we can create our own platform. And maybe periodically, weekly, fortnightly, monthly, quarterly, whatever way it works, we can come together having some snacks, tea, coffee, and discussing for 1 hour. And it will increase the knowledge of everyone. Rather than in that situation, what will happen, like a joint family culture. As of now, most of the families are individual families, unit system. And any problem we face, we have to handle ourselves. When we have joint family, different people are well connected with different social organizations, and problems become easy to handle. But here, when we are although independent practitioner, but if we develop working in a group and developing the expertise, then experts are always working as a team. They never fight with each other. And then knowledge of everyone is at one place. Everyone becomes equally conversant with the same intent of the provisions. And then accordingly, they can upgrade their income or tools and techniques, whatever is required. And that is how I can say the word future outlook of CA profession versus RERA is visible. Otherwise, it will remain like a session. So many networking and partnership seminars are happening. I don't know how many of us really connecting to each other. Really, we got connected as a network or as a partner or having the trust on each other. The foundation of network and partnership is the trust, reliability. Believing that one is expert in particular thing, if we can connect, then he can take it forward rather than like becoming a stuck point. One the who is moving also gets stuck with non-moving partner. These are the some fundamental things which we have to really see in our own self. Then once we ourselves are equipped with these things, then no one is going to stop you. Aaj hum kehte hain ki RERA mein, if we are in Mumbai kind of city, we cannot even see 3 figures. We cannot count. In this WRC, I never seen more than 25. 25 is the average figure, if we
highest
can say.
Highest optimistic.
The highest average figure. Mostly we can see, even today, how many?
14.
As of now, 40.
40.
Including us?
No.
तो 14 प्लस 5 हम मिलके 19 हो गए. मतलब दो रीजन तो इधर भी नहीं है, जबकि हम वेस्टर्न इंडिया की बात करें, बॉम्बे भी नहीं. व्हेन वर्चुअल थिंग्स आर आल्सो अलाउड, दिस इज द रियल इन रियल लाइफ आल्सो. आई मीन टू से व्हेन वी विल इंक्रीज आवर प्रैक्टिसिंग फोरा इन दिस एरिया, देन आवर नॉलेज एंड कंपटीशन विल आल्सो इंक्रीज, बिकॉज वी विल फाइट फॉर हैविंग द एक्स्ट्रा ऑर्डिनरी क्वालिटी इन आवर प्रोफेशन रादर देन फाइटिंग टू reduce the fees to match with the lower fees. This is a very strong intention to have this kind of group seminars. Otherwise, if you see, then whatever I can experience in my practice, whenever promoter is asking something, I can have some experience ki architect, engineer, advocate, they never ever give them the authentic or confident reply of particular thing how they can do in the RERA. They trust only on the chartered accountants. This is what I could understand in my life. So many developers have said ki acha aap aisa bol rahe ho to hum apne architect ko bolte wo aapse samajh lenge. This is the thing which is happening apparently. An architect ko sirf paisa chhapna hai. Ek project mil gaya 25 lakh 50 lakh ka unka fees hota hai. और हम लोग है जो पूरे 50 लाख का सारे प्रैक्टिस को जोड़ने से भी नहीं होता है, वो एक प्रैक्टिस में उतना निकालते हैं. तो व्हाट इज समथिंग विच इज द गैप, व्हाई वी कांट टेक दिस मच, एटलीस्ट रीजनेबल परसेंटेज ऑफ द प्रोजेक्ट कॉस्ट. इफ दे आर चार्जिंग फॉर द होल प्रोजेक्ट 50 लाख और 1 करोड़ 25 लाख मे बी ऑफ 3 years to 5 years, व्हाई कांट वी आर गिविंग एवरीथिंग. Even architect is asking us, ki ye main jo kiya hai, aap kaisa bol rahe ho, kya karu phir isme? They never object. Whatever we say right or wrong, they do that way. पहले उनका एक्सपर्टीज है ठीक है, प्लानिंग अथॉरिटी से वो अप्रूवल आते हैं, एक्सपर्टीज है उनका, ऑब्वियसली व्हाट एवर दे आर टेकिंग वी आर नॉट कंपटीशन, बट हमारा अपना तो लेवल ऊपर होना चाहिए. दिस इज व्हाट आई थिंक.
आर्किटेक्ट इज पेड ओनली फॉर वैल्यू एडिशन, दैट हाउ मच मोर एफएसआई कैन जनरेट फॉर द डेवलपर, हाउ मच मोर स्पेस ही कैन give to the developer, which developer can ultimately convey to the customer that this is a usable carpet, though may not be a RERA carpet. But then that is the expertise of architect. Otherwise, nobody developer is competent enough to manage the corporation in all. Right. These are the competence of architect. Now, recently there is some change in the form, or all the forms are changed on 20th December.
Yes.
So, after the in February, when we sent one form, form number one, to one of the architect, he said, I have been signing from January till date the old form only. No developer has come to us saying that these are the new format. So why you are asking this new format? You give me circular, otherwise I will not issue the form, form number one. Then I told him on phone, boss, you are signing the form, you are supposed to know the act under which you are signing the form, whether that act has undergone some change or not.
Right.
He said, no, I will not give form unless you give me the circular. Then I told the builder also, okay, see, this is his duty to look at the form because he is signing. Then ultimately we gave him circular and then he issued the form number. So these are the scenario. Okay, chartered accountant is more alert than other professionals.
Yes.
So far as RERA is concerned. Architect and engineer are the part of it, but we have seen there are hardly any engineer who will give his fair estimate. He will say, "By books mein kya hai?" See, this should be avoided. Like when a developer comes for registration of project, he is always in hurry. I want a registration number within 10 days. So the person, chartered accountant or any person who is doing the RERA registration, never bother to even sit with the developer and ask certain question, how much period he is going to take, whether he has prepared any cash flow statement for say 4 years, whether he has plan A, plan B. Like today he is presuming that allotted fund will come this way, but tomorrow it may not come. Then what is the plan, plan A, plan B and all these things. So I have observed that though it may not help at that point of time, we may not succeed at that point of time, but suppose that developer become a big developer or one of the partner of that developer joins the big group, then he remembers, yes, this is the right person we should contact, because he looks into the other aspect also and not only the form filling aspect like RERA registration, just upload PAN number, CC, this, that, you will get the number. This should not happen. So we have to discuss with the developer the project on table first, then the project on land should start. If we can convey this to the developer, like about educating the landowner or the society, now the society is also made promoter compulsorily by MRERA recently. Now in case of redevelopment, it is very difficult to convince a society. So there also challenge is there. So there also we can talk to the society people, and that way we get a mouth advertisement, like we are known that way only. Okay, yes, this person is competent, this consultant is competent enough, he looks at the thing other in a different perspective, and then the work definitely comes. But then we have to give justice to our work. Now it should not be like project registration came, we all fill in the blank and finish the like RERA carpet, what is the apartment RERA, that anybody can do. Even a BCom student can also do that. So there is nothing. Many developers are doing their own registration with their own team also. They don't even consult, but later on they realize okay, where they made a mistake. We have seen practically, if I start talking, I can take 5 hours also on practical difficulty of what mistake developer made while registering the project. So these are the, so we have to gear up. We have to change our mindset. We have to look, we have to sit in the place of developer and see how we can be beneficial to the organization. Then they will certainly retain chartered accountant and give the value addition also. Now there are, because of COVID, there are n number of scenario where there are restructuring within the project, sometime within the organization, sometime some outside organization is coming, taking over some part. There are n number of permutation combination in which the project is given outside support, maybe by way of investor or by way of equity and all these things. So there also there is change in the hand, maybe not full 100% change, but sizable. So then section 15 is there, which is very crucial. I would say section 15, if I have to look, only chartered accountant can tackle section 15. I would say like this, not even the legal fraternity, because now the Maharaja is also asking many information, like in form 3 and form 5 also they have started asking sources and application of fund. So what I suggested is cash flow statement. That will help us. If we tell the developer, you prepare this, so that could take the, so same way section 15 also, when somebody wants to take over, so there also he has to prove, okay, what is the balance cost to complete, how he is going to complete it. So entire all this year we can have good amount of exposure, expertise, and I think that is section 15 is the only field where chartered accountant can be more helpful than advocate. Yeah, advocates would be helpful in documentation, when the documents are prepared, shareholder agreement, whatever XYZ is there. So there they can, but section 15 is very, very important, because now that things are started because of FDI, relaxation in FDI cap on in the real estate market. So that also has started. Like I know one group where now Chinese company through Singapore, and they are coming into India and they are taking stake in the entire project, all many projects of the same group. And there they are looking for some local consultant. See, they have their own legal expertise, international experts are there, but they are looking for local consultant, maybe for liaising with the Maharera authority whenever, because it becomes very difficult for them to do all these things. So there also our public relation, see, at Maharera also we need to show that yes, we are fair people. It is not that we just do thing to get the thing done. So we are fair in our treatment. So they also then look at us that way only. So there also we can develop a good practice of public relation. So these are the ways in which we can develop our practice in real estate particularly. It is certainly a highly paid area, because as Dilip bhai said, if the project is of say 50 crore, why can't I get 50 lakh at least out of that project in 5 years? What is wrong in that? If I am so particular, if I am giving value addition, why I cannot get 50 lakh rupees in a particular this thing, right? We should not think of quarterly updation and all this, that fees, that these are nominal fees. That is compliance update, uploading can be done by the staff of the developer. Rather, we should concentrate on training the developer staff through online virtual. Now because of this virtual, life has become easy. I can sit at my office, three, four offices of the builder can be connected, they can be trained, their admin staff, sales staff, we can train them, right? So that also is possible. Now we will take up the one of the core issue, since we are 5 years ahead, now RERA is almost 5 years is completing. Now issues of stalled project. Now today, nearly 3,500 projects are there which are stalled, where the development is halted. There could be n number of reasons, some may be on technical ground, some may be on financial ground. So here as a WRC also, I think it would be more fruitful if WRC can give some representation, okay, how we can be helpful to Maharera. Because see, Maharera is, this is a black dot on Maharera. Even after introduction of authority like Maharera, we have 3,500 stalled project. So that is a very negative figure for Maharera. So they want to reduce this number. So how it can be reduced? So naturally we need to have an ABC analysis, like project which can be completed profitably, but there the situation is who will first invest the money. Allottee do not have confidence in the developer, developer does not have fund. I have seen many projects where, say for example, cost to complete is 50 crore and receivable are 60 crore. Even forget about unsold value, I am just talking about the sold value. Now here, the allottees are afraid, they don't want to shell out the money. So how we can take up this project? Say out of 3,500, I can see 1,500 project maybe in this category, where if the funds can be arranged of the allottee, taking into them confidence, and how we can put our suggestion before MARERA, like let there be a special account where allottee representative are also there, developer representative also there, and let the complete get. It has happened in many projects. Now today only there was one news, I think UP Rera or somewhere, they have bailed out 8 projects under Section 8, which MARERA has not done today. Not a single project in Maharashtra. So here as a WRC, as a chartered accountant, we should give how we can bail out the project. So this also we have to represent before the learned chairperson, because he is interested in bailing out the project.
Yes.
So there also we have the opportunity. See, whenever we get involved into a stalled project functioning, there also we have a, because allottee will get confidence only and only if there's some outsider neutral person are coming and monitoring the project progress rather than developer own team. Because project is already delayed and see, we can very well convince the allottee, those who have invested 40 lakh and now only 10 lakh is pending. So in one of the allottee games, why I should give 10 lakh rupees, I have already given 40 lakh rupees, and many people were there. Then we told them, okay, if you don't give these 10 lakh rupees in a special account, we don't tell okay, you give to developer, you keep in a special account, let it be countersigned by both the party, otherwise your 40 lakh is gone. So you are getting your house, you assume that you are getting your house in 10 lakh rupees.
Correct.
So that is a capital gain for you. Otherwise your 40 lakh is gone. So then they start realizing it, and even this idea we have put before the MARERA also. So now we have to focus on this, how to bail out the project from the stalled project. Now, because now insolvency proceedings are also there in on many projects, and there are good judgments where allottee interest is being protected by the Supreme Court. So wherever there is a project specific, see what happens in insolvency also, if a corporate entity is having 10 projects and only in 2 projects financial creditor has given the loan, and if all the 10 projects are dragged into insolvency, then it's a difficulty, because like yesterday only Supertech went into insolvency. I think figure is 25,000 allottees are at stake. So now they may have a situation where there are many projects, but only some projects are in financial difficulty, or other project can be bailed out by way of another contribution by allottee. It may happen that the contribution allottee may have to shell out more fund also. But there also, with the support of MARERA and WRC, we can certainly represent, and because this is our foremost duty. Because otherwise, under construction project, the confidence will be lost. If this is the situation, and that is not good for the economy. Forget about developer, forget about allottee. Real estate project is not there, then both will not be there. Yes, Sunil?
Yeah, very rightly said. See, one more issue here is that I don't know how many of us have really educated the developer about the penal provisions. Because unless you explain to them that there is a penalty which can be imposed upon them for non-performance, they will not perform. So it's our duty as professionals to make them understand what are the contributions of law which they are doing day in, day out. We find so many developers who are doing wrong things, and we just put a blind eye to that. It is our duty as a custodian, because this is a law. When the MARERA expects you to be the custodian of the law, the RERA authorities want you to make sure that project goes in the right fashion. So this is the time that you are supposed to educate your developers about the compliances, about the prevention of wrongdoings, about the penal provisions, what can happen to them in case they don't perform. All this is not educated to the developers. It is our prime responsibility as a professional handling RERA to make sure that the developer is aware of these penal provisions. After only he will understand the importance of the service that you are going to render to him. Unless he is aware that non-performance will lead to contravention and penalty, he will not give you the amount of importance that you expect from him. I will just give you an example. In addition to this, in a concession proceedings, people say there is no money left in that. Because what do you want to do? Builder will sit and we can, you know, they will settle the issue. There is no role for a charter accountant. It is absolutely wrong. I can tell you that myself and Mr. Ramesh Prabhu, we were having a concession process where we were opposing each other. And honest to God, the moment the authority saw both of us standing there, the authority told us that you two gentlemen are in a better position than us to get a result out of this complaint. Better sit down together and find a solution. And within one night, we left from the RERA office at 3 o'clock. We sat at 5 o'clock with the clients. And at 10:30 in the night, we had reconciled the whole issue and we could immediately file the consensus within 3 days. The fees that we got were much, much more than what we expected. Because otherwise the matter would have dragged for long. There would have been tension for the allottee as well as for the developer. So we, as conciliators, as good chartered accountants, knowing the subject well, we could easily find a solution and we could get good amount of professional fees also. So a good chartered accountant can act as a conciliator also, as a good mediator also. I had to explain to my client what can be the ramification in case he doesn't mend his ways. Same way, Prabhu sir had to tell the authority that you are demanding something which is not allowed under the law. It is wrong. Don't go in for that. Because we two are going to fight the battle, it is going to be a long-drawn battle and nobody is going to keep the weapons down. It's better that we don't fight and get a solution at the earliest. So friend, this is a potential in case you understand the law, you know your strength, you know your weaknesses, you are in a position to influence the client, the developer, about what best can be done in a given situation. Instead of dragging the matter for long and getting penalized, it is better that it is your duty as a chartered accountant to help out a developer, make him aware exactly what the law says, make him aware what are his faults that he has committed, make him aware what are the lack of defense that he has got. After educating him, if you give him a decision, he will be in a better position to accept a decision. And at that point in time, he will feel, yes, he is a chartered accountant, he is advising me in the right manner and making me free from all these tensions and the penal provisions in the future. So friend, that is an area where we can do a lot of things. And that is the area which can give us a lot of money. But the disputes in real estate run into crores of rupees. So the moment we settle the issue, I am very sure each one of us had almost got 5 lakh rupees each for that effort of one night, right? But it was worth a few crores for the clients. For them, it was a great achievement. And we could, you know, give him that space that he could function properly in the future without any hindrance. So friend, that is an area where you specialize. Specialization is with us. It is our job to find the place to utilize the experience and expertise and make money out of it. See, making money is incidental. In case you get on the table your expertise and experience, money is bound to come. There is no way the money will not come. Don't look at the money side first. Look at your experience and expertise and what you are going to add on the table. What is your value addition to the project? In case you can convince the client that there is a value addition because of me, then money is automatically going to follow. See, the architects and the engineers, they charge on percentage basis because they show to the client that with my help, we are in a position to complete the building, construct the building in a desired manner and get the required sales. We have to establish ourselves that yes, we are contributing to that process. Because we are there, we are in a position to smoothly run the project, complete the project and make your earning. So in case you decide and you can convince him that I am a part of the earning process, then they will be happy to pay you the money. Just issuing a certificate in a one quarter blindly, you will not get any money. If you have that intention, please don't enter into this practice. This is not for you. But to enter into this practice, you should be ready right from day one to sit with the developer, understand his problems,
sit with the developer, to give him solutions, to talk to the other professionals, give them your suggestions, get them in sync with you, all that you have to do. So there is a proactive role to be played by you. We are used to playing only a role of an accountant. We sit on our table, we don't volunteer to go out of the office. We just want things to be happening in our office. Not the right way of doing things.
Basically, we do post-mortem.
We do post-mortem. Here, we should be proactive. In case we are proactive, then your content will be seen by the developer. One small thing, you know, an advertisement wrongly issued can lead to huge penalty. In case you will convince and inform and educate a developer that is a wrong thing you are doing, don't do this, then that itself can erase that penalty provisions from his mind and be happily doing the job. One simple thing, like for example, if that client is saying that I am going to give you Jaguar fittings or similar fittings or similar type, that is not done, that doesn't allow you that. You have to specify exactly what you are going to provide. You can't make general statements now. Those things are gone. So you have to make sure that the client is aware of the responsibility cast upon him. Simply like carpet area. Still we find developers selling on the basis of sellable area, built-up area. It is not done. It is not allowed under the law. It is your duty to educate the client that, look, carpet area is the base. This is the way you are supposed to sell. This is not the way. You have to sell only on the basis of carpet area as per RERA and nothing more than that. You have to educate the client so he can educate his sales team how to project the sale, how to effect the sales. So friends, everywhere in RERA, each of every section, you'll find a lot of opportunity. That opportunity depends on you, how best you can encourage that. All yours.
Sir, just I would like to interfere. Whatever you said now, I'd like to share my personal experience. One of the good developer in Western suburbs having multiple projects. In some of the projects, the developer had availed the facility of 50% remission in the development charges on the pretext that he's not going to charge stamp duty to his customers. Now, I'm sitting with that developer in his cabin discussing some things. Before that, I was interacting with his administrative and accounting staff. At there, I noticed that there are some letters being sent to the allottees for stamp duty payment. And when I came to know that this is what is the concession he has opted out from the MCGM, and when I told him that your staff is sending the stamp duty demand for the allottees, because he was supposed to recover that money, but in the name of the cost towards the flat, not in the name of the stamp duty. And his staff was sending the reminders in the name of the stamp duty. So that is the way, or that is the what he was saved from the future, let us say litigation or whatever.
Certain.
So that was the small thing, just to interact with the staff, and that was brought to the notice of the developer.
Correct.
Yes, sir.
Good. I could see. First of all, rather than sharing my experience, getting some experience, I can say take away for me from Ashwin Bhai as well as Sunil Ji. What is that takeaway? In the conciliation, normal perception is once builder will sit with the allottee, they will settle, and then the cost of the litigation which the professional used to get in regular hearing through the RERA will be reduced or will not be given, right? Was substantial perception. But today I can get, rather than having this perception demolished, creating opportunity. Being a conciliator, learned faculty, and educating both the parties, whomsoever we do represent, whether builder or LOT, and trying to be someone who is resolving issues rather than creating more difficulties. Because they do not understand much things, they trust on what we say. And what is the normal understanding is, advocates are litigants. This is what normal, I don't say in general, but normal tendency is that advocates create problems to maintain the longevity of the cases so that they can get more and more for the per hearing or cases.
I would say like this. They are the more eager to file the case and also more eager to settle the case.
Yes, that's
out of
true.
Court.
This is what I have seen.
Okay.
They don't want to go to the court for every hearing and all these things, unless the matter is on very high end or like that. But they are more eager to settle.
And they are more aware about the repercussions.
Huh.
Rather than us, they are they also to visualize everything.
Maybe there are.
They know where to press the button, like where to pinch.
There are cases where they fix the lump sum fees for a particular case, then they want to go out without lingering the case, and so that their fees is secured. This may be the one of the, but whatever experience Aswin bhai said is not mine. My experience is different. And I can see in the civil courts and other places where my perception is confirmed. They don't want to resolve things. They want to linger the things. Now here, this is the opportunity for us being honest in our profession, being social people in the society where the people are having more trust on chartered accountants, and we are allowed to practice to lead for attending the litigations. It can be filing complaint or attending on behalf of both the parties or going to the tribunal. In all the situations, I am getting upgraded. My knowledge, my qualities, and what I am dealing with right now is, first of all, initially I was dealing with how to file particular application, whether in appeal requires lot of intricacies, where technical it is. It may not be accepted. And then they started asking certain new terms, which I was not aware, and even not finding any solution in any of the books or even in the case laws. And those will depend on how much we have really worked with someone who is really practicing in this particular area. So these are the challenges for new entrants. One has to be trained enough.
Yes.
Like article clerk, we have to be working with someone seniors. And then we can jump into such kind of specialized area. Another thing is, there are communication and argumental skills and abilities. As a chartered accountant, I am very much aware about facts. I am very much aware about the case laws or some sections, subsections or some circulars. But when time comes to argue things, we are slower, we speak less, we don't increase tone and reduce tone at particular time. And I see that there is a spoke, there is a gap, and that gap can be fulfilled only when हमारे सी ए फ्रेटर्निटी के लोग ज़्यादा अच्छे होंगे, उनके बीच में हमारा इंटरेक्शन होता है. आज हम आप जो बैठे हैं, इनमें यदि हाई लो पिच का खुद ही प्रॉब्लम है, तो वो हमें कैसा मिल सकता है? जिनसे हम सीख रहे हैं उनके पास जितना, उससे ज़्यादा कैसा मिलेगा आपको? तो काइंड ऑफ थिंग इज रिक्वायर्ड. आप में बहुत से ऐसे टैलेंटेड लोग टीवी में छिपे हुए अभी, जिसे बाहर लेके आना है. आपका टैलेंट वो एरिया हमारे में गैप है, वो हम सीखेंगे आपसे. हमें जो प्रैक्टिकल कुछ चीज़ें मालूम है, वो आप सीख सकते हो. तो दिस इज हाउ इट कैन बी कम्प्लीमेंटेड सप्लीमेंटेड.
बट देन इफ एवरीबॉडी इज मैरिड, देन ही नोज हाउ टू आर्ग्यू. बेटर ऑफ इज ऑलवेज आर्ग्यूइंग.
बोलो लाइक एंड
इंडिया में 130 करोड़ हमेशा मोदी जी बोलते हैं, मैं नहीं बोलता हूँ, कितने पता नहीं मुझे. तो उसमें यदि मैरिड का अपने 35 एंड एबव वाले का देखेंगे, तो समझो सब शादीशुदा हो सकते. तो वो आर्गुमेंट से वो कोई कम्पीट नहीं कर सकते. ये स्पेशलाइज लो है.
बट दे नो हाउ टू आर्ग्यू, हाउ टू फेस द आर्ग्यू आल्सो.
आई शेयर, सी मी एंड लाइक सर एट स्टार्टिंग में एकदम, वी यूज्ड टू सिट इन द एपेलेट ट्रिब्यूनल टू सी हाउ द एडवोकेट्स
आर. दैट वाज आई आल्सो स्टार्टेड दैट वे.
दिस वाज द फुल डे इन ट्रिब्यूनल.
इवन एट वन पॉइंट ऑफ टाइम learned chairperson Indira madam asked me,
why are you sitting, sir?
Not why are me, you have any matter? Means she thought ke I have some recipe, I want to move that. So you have anything, please tell, because she knows that chartered accountant, she is a chartered accountant. So
acha, she is
she knows that I am a chartered accountant. So then she gives sometime that benefit of convenience to us.
Gentle.
But that starting point, I also started like that only. Whenever I used to go, I just used to go and sit.
Yeah.
I used to go at 10-15 so that I get a seat.
Yes.
First of all. And then I sit at the corner and I listen to
us.
And really, yes, some of the advocates were arguing the matter.
in a very nice manner. Yes. Sometimes they become angry also before the judge. But then that angriness,
that anger is justified.
Is a merit.
In the voice modulation, basically, yeah. The dramatics that they do, you know, all that we have to learn.
Sometimes they say, with two folded hands, we request, like this. We are in the hand of the your lordship and all these things. So all that we have to learn, because this is an art.
Yes.
Correct. We are a commerce student. This is an art.
Even bringing an NOT into the courtroom and asking him to beg or asking him or her in that kind of tone, you know, like, ki amala nyay diya, like this. So, yes, this is done.
Yes. It makes a huge difference.
Yes, absolutely. Yes.
And then we have to learn decorum also of the court, because we are the officer of the court. Whenever quasi-judicial as well as judicial, we are the officer of the court. So we have to, when other is speaking, we have to keep quiet. If you want to say something, we have to raise our hand and all these things. So we should not be an interrupter. So that image we have to maintain. Otherwise, they will they pick up, okay, yes, this fellow is in one, two advocate cases. One of the member very rightly mentioned, अरे जब भी आपका weakness का point है ना appeal का, तो आपका volume online पे कम हो जाता है। So this is also they understand.
But this can be, you know, easily learned by all of us, because we are basically chartered accountants, so we understand the law. So this mannerism, this dramatism, the voice modulation can be easily acquired from expert skills. See, we are not experts right now. But we have to understand this skill from the solicitors, the advocate. We have to sit down the appellate tribunal for us together to understand the matter. Even the members, how they react to a situation, that will come to know only after you have sat there for us together to understand what is the dynamics of that. So this is a learning process, and nobody can say that I have learned the whole process. It is a continuous learning process, so we can easily learn that. It's not impossible. But I tell you honestly that when there's an advocate on the other end, I'm more comfortable. Because I feel that, you know, I have an advantage because I understand the law, plus I understand the numbers also. He only understands the law, he doesn't understand numbers. So you have an advantage and you can take him around in the number game and you can earn bonus point out of that. That's your skill. So, you know, you have to understand that also. And the most important thing that in litigation you have to understand is that what is going to come to the other side. People make wrong promises to the developers. It is absolutely wrong. Or the authorities also. Not done.
Yes. You should never promise that.
It is not in your hand. You are not a chairperson of Mahara. You have to tell him the facts of life. You can indicate to him how they behave in such a situation. What justice they have given in the past. That is the indication. You cannot promise anything to anybody. And most important thing is that after doing your efforts, you should make him aware that I have done my best in the given situation. That awareness should be brought on the record. That is the only thing which is going to give you the professional peace. In case you don't educate him, don't interact with him, then your efforts go down the drain. To make your efforts successful, though the result may be against you, but the client should get that feeling from you. What is best in the given situation has been done by this person. And to do that and to gain that expertise, to understand what is going to come to the other side. So in our office, myself and Sumit, when we get any allotty, any case, whether for allotty or a developer, we argue the case. I say, you go on the other side, I'll be on this side. Let's argue the case. We make all of our study, we argue the case. I say, he's going to fight on the allotty side, I'm going to fight on the developer side. And then we get a lot of insight, something which I've not understood, you know, because I'm only looking for one side. He can tell you other insight about the other side also, the story. So that can give you better value addition, so you're well prepared. When the argument comes on the other side, during the course of the litigation process, you are ready for that. This you have to, you know, slowly have to inculcate all these habits, you know, in your process. Then you can be successful. You can't be successful just by reading those three sections of the law. It is all that mechanism of the law, the implementation of the law, the behavior of the authority, all that has to be understood, and then you can be a good, successful professional.
Now, I'll just cite one example, recent order passed by the chairperson, where the things were very clear. Like, anybody will say, yes, I am confident you will get the justice, allottee. To the allottee, like there was a delay, sizable delay, and refund case and all these things. So everything was in favor of the allottee. So any advocate or any will tell with the confidence, yes, yes, aapka kaam ho jayega. So then, now in that case, what has happened? The agreement was prior to RERA. Date of possession was after RERA, and there was a delay. But there was one arbitration clause in that agreement. So suddenly learned chairperson emphasized on that and said, okay, no, arbitration clause is there, so the matter should be decided by arbitrator and not by the RERA authority. Now here, it was a shock to all of us. Now, both the advocates were very competent. I know both of them. So it was not that it was not properly argued. But sometimes this kind of situation also come. So there a lot of people tell you, boss, aapne to mereko bola tha aapka kaam ho jayega. Abhi kya? So here, then after that, again, now the allottee cannot afford writ petition and all this thing, cost. So that was a fit case if somebody want to go for writ also, writ of mandamus. But then allottee, again, because their cost is involved, you have to employ councils and all this. So then the appeal is filed. But this kind of situation can also come. So you cannot be sure. See, yes. Geez, we will do our task.
Yes.
But decision, we have seen many order of earlier chairperson.
Yes, yes.
You take judgment. You take judgment.
So many such judgments are there where we are helpless. I have one or two cases which I have taken up in 2018. Complaint was filed by us in 2018. Today it is before High Court in second appeal for deciding who is the promoter, because there were two promoters, outgoing and incoming. Our agreement was with outgoing, and now incoming is completing the project. So the adjudicating officer has given the order, okay, both are jointly and severally liable. So there the issue before my court is under 43(5), who is the promoter? So since only we are stuck on there only in High Court. And now High Court is saying, since this project is of Nagpur, the Nagpur bench High Court will look, will hear this, not the Mumbai High Court. So all this thing can come up. Yes. We have to be very, very careful in drafting our scope of work. Whenever we take any assignment, we should be fair in our
About this new tech judgment only. Same developer, same project, four allottees. Out of those, mostly in the gap of 3 months, two group complaints were filed. One person got the favorable order in the authority, got the favorable order in the appellate tribunal, and now it is in second appeal. High Court, Bombay High Court has directed the developer to deposit 100% money, and then only they are going to listen. So other two gentlemen, not that much lucky, because when their matter was placed for the final order, new tech judgment came, and then the appellate tribunal said, no, your matter has been decided by the adjudicating officer, we are going to send back this matter again to the authority. So they are back to square one, where they started in 2018.
Yes, yes. That has happened in many cases.
Yes.
Thousand matters.
Yes, that has happened. So we should be very, very careful. It is not that whenever work comes, just take it, grab it. We should be very careful and more careful while dealing with the allottee.
Yes.
Developer can afford
litigation.
N number of cost. If we tell them do this, he will do that also. We say if you want to employ a senior counsel, he will do that also. But allottee, when it comes,
It is difficult for
allottee to spend them, because if we appoint a senior counsel for one hearing and on that particular day hearing does not happen, then what? They are going to charge. So these are the issues.
And some of the litigation related practical aspect which I could relate is, we at least first step of filing the complaints is very easy. For practicing chartered accountant who want to come into the practice, can begin with normal practice as well as appearing before the RERA authorities regarding various other matters, including the complaints. And thereafter, they can increase their knowledge base and then go up to any level. This is what I can conclude at this point. And second point is, there are same situations, but nowadays, expected results are not happening because of certain twist, because of certain other RERA orders, tribunal orders, or High Court or Supreme Court orders, which usually we being into practice, not much aware about those facts. What are those judgments? So we should increase our such knowledge so that whatever may be the case, you can turn around. At times the same case is in your favor, and at times it is against your expectations. These both things are happening in RERA.
Yes, that is true. But even for filing the complaint, because that is the prime document. Because matter can go up to High Court.
Yeah.
And in High Court, the opponent will say, look at the complaint. He has not given the grounds and relief. So High Court will say, nothing doing, quash the complaint. So complaint itself being a prime document should be well prepared, well drafted, with all evidence, affidavits, whatever.
Sure.
It has to be done. See, many people just file a complaint. I have seen many complaints. Just a four-line here, four-line statement of facts, four-line relief claim. And two documents are uploaded. So that is not the way. We have to prepare index, exhibits, and all these things. So that shows our professionalism.
Exactly. Then only can charge something. No?
Yes, then
you
only.
You can write only eight lines
yes.
on a complaint. What that will do to pay?
Correct.
Sir, if you draft it properly. One more thing, which is form number A or B, specify format. I can see some deficiency in the format. There is no facts column, no grounds column, only one. Straight away and then going directly to the relief or interim relief.
No, there is statement of facts in form.
Grounds and both things are combined.
In continuation,
facts as well as grounds are coming.
You can separately statement of facts, grounds and relief.
Relief claim. What is the interim relief? That also is very important.
Yes,
what are the grounds?
If you just put the relief claim, that I want to purchase the flat, what is the immediate relief you want right now? There may be some interest going on, there may be some loan being taken by the developer, not known to you, expansion in the project, change of developer, all that may be happening. That also to be included in the complaint.
Right.
You are not only asking for your flat, you are asking about the entire dynamics of the project. That has to be understood by the person who to file the complaint. And there you can find a lot of faults which the developer has committed. When your complaint becomes stronger, if you put all those facts on the record, then there is a better possibility. They will come to you on the negotiation table
yes.
and then compromise the issue. The complaint should be that word. Wherein the developer will understand.
His advocate should tell.
So in case that is communicated, then it will happen very fast. Otherwise, they will be in a hunky-dory situation.
I will agree with Sunil. In one of the leading developer, top five, I would not name it. There was a forfeiture case in my client. He has paid 15 lakh rupees and within 5 days he decided I do not. That was called a reservation and booking form and all these things. And then he said, I don't want to go for it. Please refund my money. Then that reputed developer said, no, our policy does not permit us to refund because the flat value was of 4 crore rupees. It was under construction. So 15 lakh is just 4% for a developer, but for the senior citizen, that was a big amount. So then that LOD came to us. So then we made some R&D. What we have done is his flat was then surrendered, and then we find out from public search what developer has done with this flat. So we could find that within 7 months he has sold that flat at a value more than the previous value by 40 lakh rupees.
Right.
So that was one point which I could take, that there is no loss to the developer. For forfeiture claim, Indian Contract Act is there. It has to be, loss should be reasonable and it should be proved by the opponent party whenever there is a breach of contract. So on this point, now we have filed the complaint covering all this exhibit, index and all. So now that reputed developer in conciliation, they came to certain terms, but still they are not up to that mark. They go very slowly. But we are much sure okay, with this, okay, they have not sustained any loss. For forfeiture, you have to prove that you have sustained the loss. Because of my brief, you have sustained the loss. You are allowed to forfeit
the
amount.
Absolutely.
That is not even 15 lakhs. You can ask more also if the price has gone down. But here, after 7 months, they have sold for more than what? Like the original price was 4.4 crore. He has sold for 4.8 crore. So such kind of R&D we have to do.
Yes.
Sometimes you have to go out of the box.
Absolutely.
And this LOD said, yeah, we never knew this. He said, you go and search.
Correct.
Give me the index two of that.
That's flat.
Yes. So then now our case is very. Now to the best of my knowledge, Marera is also planning to come out with some notification or circular stating the reasonability of the forfeiture. They are envisaging, because this was the talk in conciliation where the conciliator told me if they are coming, only 10% of the paid amount can be forfeited, not more than that. So conciliator also
of the paid amount.
Yes. So conciliator also told them, look, your matter will then come in newspaper. It is better you settle here. Now this big corporate.
But you know what happens, that in most of the cases, the matter is not communicated to the proper top management. And be handled by the legal department.
Legal department.
And for their own whims and fancies, they do not let that matter go up to the
top management.
And because that is the loss of the top management. That they should understand that. But sometimes it so happens that at that level, they try to manipulate and manage the thing. And then they end in a difficult situation.
And how to handle then this situation? How to approach up to the top level?
So not possible for us. Not possible. Find out the way.
See, have access. See, you can put mails to them. Then try to get more information. You know, whatever is possible. See, yes. As you rightly said, you hunt for the index too. You hunt for it. You do the R&D for that. You can't say, "Where will you get it?" There are ways of doing it, right? So you have to take all the efforts required and then get to this. See, one index two is going to turn the case on his side totally. But now we can easily justify. There is no case on the other side. I am going to unless this is a loss. And that R&D is going to help the client. See, in that situation, when the client is put to a loss of 10 lakh rupees, if Ashwin tells him tomorrow, with my efforts, I am in a position to save that money for you, he will easily pay him 1 lakh rupees as a fees and he will be happy about it. And Ashwin has saved the money. So that is what your skill is going to be.
Correct. Bilkul, absolutely.
So, this is very important. This is my skill. I can work in this. He thought about the whole dynamics, could find a solution. That is the expertise, that is the experience. So unless that comes in, no, you are not in a position to make that amount of money. Filing a complaint, like the way you issue a notice from the advocate. You go to Esplanade court, you will hire an advocate sitting in the typewriter, he will file a complaint with 500 rupees, right? Go to a solicitor, he is going to charge you 1 lakh rupees for the same complaint. So but there is a difference between two things. No? The moment that you see that name of the solicitor, otherwise says, "Bhai, better kar le yaar, let's settle the issue."
Yes, sir.
It's like that.
Correct. In fact, in one of the matter of this BKC here, where MMRDA was involved while giving the NOC, because MMRDA is a government undertaking. So there also, the one same office was sold to two persons. So my client had allotment letter, and in MMRDA record, the name of my client was there, but it was removed without his consent, which cannot be done. So we straight away filed, there was a complaint at Marara, we straight away filed a writ in High Court. And at that point of time, Justice Kathawala was there. And he is known, means developers are afraid. The moment we filed writ petition, in the evening, because when it was served to MMRDA, MMRDA might have talked to the developer. In the evening, there was a call from the developer, please come at night, 9 o'clock, we are meeting.
Correct, absolutely.
So we met from 9 to 12. Next day, he gave me just one floor above one, same office, similar. Okay, I said to my client, do it, finish it off. Registered it, khatam. But this has to be done. Means this is the way. So there we get the money. Because that office was worth 6 crore rupees.
So your work is that only, to find out exactly the intricacies of that trade and then give a solution to the client. Yes. Then you will make money. Not by just filing a complaint or issuing a certificate. It's not your job.
Now one area where I am more concerned is when there is a allottee fund and project finance by the banker, right? So developer, say for example, is doing a 500 crore revenue project where the cost is say 400 crore. 100 crore is profit. Now this 400 crore, he has taken 200 crore as a loan from the banker, right? He has his own equity of 50 crore and balance 150 is from allottee as of today. Right, so this is the source and application. So today while I sign my form 3, I am taking what cost 400 CR, right? Which includes allottee fund, equity and debt, right? Now, so his withdrawal limit is what? 400 CR, right? And he has, but that withdrawal, we have to bifurcate this withdrawal limit in two parts. One is allottee part. The allottee fund he can certainly withdraw because he has realized money from the allottee. But what about the banker loan? Because if he does not pay to the bank, then that encumbrance will remain on the project land.
Correct.
So what we suggested to Mahara is you reduce this project cost from 400 for this bank finance and make it a special for only for withdrawal for bank only. Otherwise, tomorrow it may happen, the builder will take away all the money and then banker is saying, no, I have the mortgage over the project land and then allottee will not get the conveyance and all these. So this is very alarming situation. So see, now in RERA also frauds were committed like subvention. अभी 5% भरो आराम से सो जाओ 95% बाद में भरो वो उसका आराम से सोने का कभी हुआ ही नहीं एन नंबर ऑफ पीपल हु हैव इन दैट दे आर सफरिंग कि अभी तो खाली अपने को 5 लाख भरना है और स्टैंप ड्यूटी का 7-8 लाख भरना है 12 लाख भर के 1 करोड़ का अपना प्लेट तभी तक हम प्लान कर लेंगे देन कोविड केम एवरीथिंग स्टार्टेड सो हियर दैट वॉज वन वे ऑफ looping the LOD. Now this is also alarming situation. So this also we explained to Mahara, but they are not ready to listen. In fact, myself and Aditya, we have given a detailed presentation now to the secretary and his entire team. And almost everybody agreed what we were telling.
Correct.
But when the secretary took it to the chairperson, he said, no, this is the task of chartered accountant. So tomorrow, when the project is under danger, who will be looked into?
Correct.
Chartered accountant. You did not bring these facts in form 3.
Correct. Absolutely.
So what? How to handle this? That is also a big challenge.
Big challenge. Yeah. Big challenge.
Because in form 3, we do not find any column where we can write that this is the money cost incurred out of the bank fund. Now at least they have given sources and application incurred. So that column is there now. But while computing withdrawal limit, this is missed out. Today now they have sources and application where we can write what is the debt and this thing.
Means of finance.
Means of finance and all that. But otherwise this is a alarming situation. Because it has happened in many projects. Bank loan remain as it is. And then there
application
is...
Sources to hai, application hai,
hai?
Application kidhar hai form 3 mein
kya
sources to hai
application means your cost incurred
cost incurred
see cost incurred is your application so source you have to give bifurcate
I mean to say 30% cost incurred is cost incurred but based on that they are withdrawing the money and not paying to the bank that secured loan or unsecured loan remained as it is If you see the 3 days, 4 days back, Kathawala issued one order wherein my building, that order is came.
Achha, same order last order of Kathawala.
Kathawala. Very last order of his retirement is for our building. Whereas builder did not pay money to the Anandraki. And RERA does not take care of anything about the borrowed money. And they are allowing anything. They are not putting any condition for having those funds to be kept under escrow or somewhere which can be taking care of the project while allotted money is very small that is taken care by 70-30 but there is no tax on the bank's finance this why this regulators or government is not understanding why we are as a WRC representative strongly representing here as well as to central government If central government makes some changes, will be applicable to the whole country. I think it will, somebody need to initiate as a representative of the CA fraternity. Otherwise, Ashwin Bhai said ki CA log dekhenge. Means, hamara marzi aayega jab hum unpe disciplinary action le lenge. Aisa hi hona hai.
That is true.
Mujhe aap batao, koi bhi builder ke against mein, overall le lo aap, samjho. Aur usne 500 crore ka loan liya hai. और जो भी कुछ कर रहा है वो कर रहा है आप उसके अरेस्ट में कि दे हैव नॉट पेड लोन बोलेगा आप क्यों लिख रहे हो वेयर रेरा आस्क यू टू राइट कमेंट्स ऑन योर रिपेमेंट व्हाई यू आर राइटिंग दिस क्वेश्चन इज से वी आर नोवेयर
आई थिंक दिलीप भाई वी शुड आस्क सम ऑफ द viewers also if they want to say anything yes we can keep the floor open those who want to contribute or any they want to share their experience or better suggestion what we have discussed today
sir can I speak sir
yes, 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 yes.
Sir, I fully agree. The only issue is that I'm really sorry I have not contributed much to the study circle in the past 2 years that I have been here. But anyway, I do a lot of property work. Understand, much of my practice is that. But on the legal side, means I am more associated with advocates. There are two things which has catched my attention. One is that undercutting between chartered accountants. That's one thing. The other thing that I've seen with advocates is, "Mera paisa pehle de, baad mein main court mein aata hoon." This is how advocates work. You know, I have a senior advocate who says that I don't have bad debts. Now, does not that sound? You know, we teach bad debts, we learn bad debts, but someone else says that I don't have any bad debts because my money comes on day one.
Because we are not married to the client. We marry to the client. Marry to the client.
But honestly speaking, in case you have the discipline, you can be successful. And I have been, the way Ashwin said, married to the client. But here is my associate Sumit. He is not at all married to the client. He will not enter the room, the tribunal, unless the past fees are paid. Two hearings he will attend. Third hearing he will send a message. I cannot attend because my two bills are pending. Simple, plain and simple. And he is very successful in that. The client has to pay, otherwise he loses the case. So it is not arm twisting, it is demanding what you are worth. So if you put it across properly, then you will get the money.
Yes, you continue.
So that is, you know, somewhere down the line, this is something in-house that we have to do with our younger fraternity also, and with our seniors. Okay, seniors, they are doing their bit. But as far as the youngers are concerned, as far as people of the cutting is concerned, understand, I was approached by one developer. I am in central Mumbai. I reside at Baikala. And he said that you have a certificate, humne bana ke rakha hai, you just sign it and we'll pay you 50,000 rupees. I said, sorry, sir, who was your earlier chartered accountant? So he gave me some name. So I said, sir, unless I talk to him, I cannot do anything. So nahi, aapko kya farak padta hai? I will pay you. I said, no, sorry, sir, I will not do it. And when I went there, he said, by, you know, the type of atmosphere they have here, I have not been paid, and, you know, all the issues there. And, you know, it was good on my part that I did not, you know, sign that certificate. But the issue here is that if someone approaches like that, if we have a discipline amongst ourselves, if we can teach our own people, like we teach our children the manners, we have to teach some manners to our own, you know, chartered accountants also. Then don't accept the assignment. And see, when it comes to lawyers, we have a very senior chartered accountant, Mr. Manoj Pandit. I attended him many a times. I believe all of you must be knowing him. He's our faculty also. He says that one case gives employment to two advocates. One for the plaintiff, one for the defendant. That is not the case with chartered accountants. One chartered accountant is given a job, taking the job of another chartered accountant.
Correct.
So, you know, these are the issues which really hurt. And I feel the pinch because I'm, you know, with a lot of advocates. So I feel that a profession where we have put in a lot of hard work, a profession who is more disciplined, more organized and everything, understand, and still we are not benefiting monetarily the way we should. That's all I have to say, sir. Thank you.
And we are less in number than as compared to advocates.
Obviously, sir.
We are just
10%. Sir, show me in the whole of India which advocate organization has an institute of charter, has a building like what we have, either in Delhi or in Mumbai.
Very true.
They are all part of the Bar Council. Understand?
Yes. Anyone else who want to share something?
Okay, it seems that we have got a very good discussion. Last to us, Aditya,
would like to conclude?
First of all, thank you all the panelists. It was a great session today, and we could, as a everyone, we look forward to you for more such interactions, because we need guidance in futures also. and you have guided us regarding the different aspects of hearing and the appellate, and you have told the younger chartered accountants to come into this practice, which we often ignore. And in every part of the act, we are the people who have kept first in that particular section also. So they expect us to be there. But as an individual, somewhere we are hesitant, although we have a hold on the act, but still we are somewhere hesitant for arguing or putting up our thoughts in the particular hearing. And this is basically because of the lack of guidance. And somewhere as a senior, we are not able to get in touch with the seniors, and we are not being able to guide by the senior. Somewhere there is a gap in the communication. That is the reason there might be people who are hesitant for this particular area of practice. But more and more, you have given a good guidance that more and more chartered accountants should come into this field. And not only our work should be restricted to the certification. And obviously, I have seen in my period of this practice that, sir, you have rightly said that people are charging much less, and many consultants have been there in this particular sector who are saying that aapko sign chahiye na to hum CA ko hamare
team hai humko de do ye advisory.
Because I visited a client recently, I told him that I provide this service, I will charge you 2 lakh rupees. What he said, your quotation is very, very high. It is 10 times higher than what I got. So that is very much, I gave him a retainership option that I will guide you right from the beginning. But still he said that, no, it is very, very higher. We have already 2 quotations which are very less than this. So you can, I told him that, yes, you can go for it, but later on you might face certain issues at your end. But this is the case that somewhere chartered accountants are also in the verge of signing. Because I have seen in study group, many are there, but the people I have seen the names, while registration we get form 3. So those names are not even there in study group. So who are these then? Where, how they know or where they are signing? And many of the forms, all the notes are not there. Only 1 page certificate has been issued for a project of 50 crores. So this is a great opportunity for us to stand somewhere, and we have been placed in this particular act very well. So we should take precaution in future also while issuing the certificate. Otherwise, we will be soon be replaced by so-called certified public accountants
or even artificial intelligence or other professionals.
So that is very well we should take care of in this future. And rightly, if it has been come from you as a senior, so I hope so our members will also understand the importance and the grievance relating to this particular subject. Thank you very well, very much, sir, for coming and giving us
thank you.
And thank you all the members who are
there on the online platform for attending the full panel discussion. This was probably the last meeting as our conveyorship. So we are glad that we got a response from you throughout the year. Many were more common faces like Sanjay sir,
Adam Musawala sir, then Lalit sir, Rashmi Lonigar madam, Uma madam. These are, they are more probably involved every meeting. So we are eager that we got your support and more sessions were conducted. Next year, new team and new members will be appointed. So thank you everyone for the
great support which you gave us.
Thank you.
Thank you. Thank you. Great year for both of you. You have taken RERA on the next level.
the
Ugh.